Parties for Possibility is a vehicle that anybody can jump onto to make a difference in the education level of our country. Whether you are a principal, first of all, to gain some experience or knowledge or support from a business leader, or secondly, when you are a business leader and you want to invest in your community with the skills that you've acquired over the however many years you've been busy. And I think that's how those two things come together for a beautiful result. For me, the relationship works best when there's a classical coach-coachee relationship where there's some structure towards what the principal wants to work on, either in school or in the person or management style. When they have identified what they want to improve and grow in that process that they contracted with Partners for Possibility. And when the business leader or /coach is clear about what they want to achieve. And I think that is something that is, that will give the results that you want at the end of the day, is when both parties are clear. Two things, I felt that I could make a difference for principals because I think that they are so focused on what they need to do on a daily basis that on a management level, they often need a lot of support. And I'm from HR and this is my daily game. So I thought that I could offer something that's valuable. And I think the second reason is I feel like education will be our game changer in South Africa. You know, there's a lot of other things that are important, but the moment you raise the education level of people in the country, that's when the country starts changing. So Charmaine was a very open person. She is a person that is really keen to get input from other people. There was an incredible willingness from her side that was very obvious for me when I met her. To engage in the process, and I think that makes a huge difference, you know, if people are willing to invest in the process. So I think that was the one thing that I really noticed about her from the start. I think the second thing that I picked up from Charmaine is she's very honest. She tells it like it is. You know, and that is incredibly valuable if you want to find out what are the big pain points or where can you support. If somebody's really transparent, it saves you the effort of working for the information, you know, or trying to figure it out. And I think those are the two things I really noticed about her very early on in our relationship. So she manages a school. She's a principal of a school which is a no-fee school. So it means the parents don't have to pay anything. So that's number one, is there's nothing to come into the school's bank account to help her manage that school, to pay the expenses. So I think that is a very challenging situation for any school. The second challenge that she has is the numbers of the school have dwindled so much that she is losing critical staff that is allocated from the Western Cape department. And that she's losing, which means that she has to absorb all of this work packages. She has to absorb it in her own capacity, or she needs to ask teachers to do it. And I think that's really hard. She fulfills a double role. She's a principal and she's a teacher. And I think that kind of school that has so many needs, you need an absolute sole focus in that. And that's really hard, you know, for principals to take on that kind of responsibility. I think Charmaine is a go-getter herself. So, you know, how I planned it in my head and how it actually happened is two different things, of course. So I had the idea to first go analysis, what's the main pain points, then make the plan, then go into execution mode, and then hopefully get the results that we're aiming for. I think the need that I picked up from her is that she doesn't necessarily need a plan because she knows what to do. So she's very capable. She's very resourceful and she's very innovative. But she needed a soft landing place as a as a person, as a principal. She needed a safe place to come and sit and talk about her daily challenges and how hard it is for her. I think in many cases she had the solution already, but she needed support from a human perspective. I feel that's the thing that I picked up the most from her last year. And maybe it's the part that I responded to because I'm also a coach. So I naturally responded to that, you know, to be the person that she could complain if things, you know, got tough for her. Well, sometimes she didn't know what to do next. Most of the time she solved her own problems, you know. And I think that was more how our relationship evolved. One of the things that I picked up early on is that as a principal, she's got very much a teacher-parent relationship with her teachers in the school. Not with with the children in the school, but with the teachers, she has a parent-teacher, a parent-child relationship. So she treats the teachers like children. She takes on all the responsibility. She wants to do everything. She wants to check everything. She wants to fix everything if it goes wrong. And I think in the process, Charmaine's teachers realize that they don't have to always do that much because Charmaine's there to fix it. And I think that's the part that I had to, I wouldn't say that I helped her to solve it, but I was definitely a sounding board to make her aware of it. That was the relationship that transpired because of the way that she dealt with her teachers. And that was definitely insightful for her, I would say. I think something that was reaffirmed for me is that people are really strong and capable if you allow them to be. And people are resourceful. I just had to reinforce all her good qualities that she already has that brought her to this place of being a principal of a very challenging school. And I had to remind her that she doesn't need me, that she is powerful and smart and capable to run this school. And I think if I look back at the kind of plans that she made without me, you know, that message for me is confirmed. She is an extremely powerful person, you know. She doesn't always strike it like that because she's very humble, but she is indeed very capable, you know, and I think that's how people are. If you give them the tools and you give them the support and you remind them that they can believe in themselves, people will rise to the occasion. I had a relationship with Elkar Zeeman before Partners for Possibility anyhow. Yeah, so I was sort of stepping into that role, which formalized things a little bit. But I was already doing, you know, fundraising for them in Germany anyway, every year for their stationery expenses. Charmaine was a new principal, though, and that she was the first principal I met in a new role. But I knew the two principals before her. So I think from my heart, I'm committed to the school with or without a formal annual program for Partners for Possibility. I think it's something that's there anyway, you know. And seeing how I can connect Charmaine to the rest of Paul and what opportunities we can get for her to stabilize her school, I think will be a natural upper. I don't think necessarily I will end up at a school every week, but I think, you know, there's already some ideas that we can take forward this year. Partners for Possibility came along with a structured framework. And I think that structured framework provided a foundation for the relationship going forward. And it was a little bit clearer what my role could be there, as opposed to whatever you want to do would be great in the past, and now it was more, there's a focus in it. Well, I'm a stickler for structure. So I always think that structure is good. And I think there are many people who are yearning to make a difference somewhere, but they don't know how to, right? And I think that is what PFP does. You know, they give a structure to it and they give a framework to it. And I think it makes it more target-driven, if I can say it like that. I think that's what makes coaches like me happy, is when you see other people grow. So that was that whole discussion about parent-child type of relationships that she had with all those critical teaching resources at her school that they have to help her to run that school. I think that was a great conversation. It was a long one, you know. And we talked about that for quite a couple of hours, you know, how she drives that kind of relationship at the school. I think that was the highlight for me, because I think she changed a lot of things after that. So I think one of the big realizations for Charmaine was that if she has a more adult-to-adult relationship in a school environment, which I think is difficult, because I think your tendency is to be parent-child in a school environment. But with the teachers who are in a team, I think she needed to be more adult-to-adult and expect them to pull their weight in the school. As a principal, she needed to learn how to believe in people and how to expect great things from people around her and not to doubt them and to continuously double check them and continuously take responsibility away from them. So there was a part that she needed to grow in, but taking that away in a parent-child relationship in a school environment doesn't allow your teachers to grow and take responsibility. So she makes the burden on her own shoulders heavier. And I think that, when she clicked that was a really great, that was a great moment for her. It's really humbling for me to, I know Alkaz Zeman for a very long time, and I know I haven't been involved in schools in South Africa since yesterday. So the environment is familiar to me, but I still think that every time you walk in there, you realize how lucky we are if your children get to go to a good school. And I think it makes me feel motivated to make a difference, because I know my kids get a good education. And it makes me feel motivated to continue to play a role, however small it is in the bigger scheme of things, but to play a role nevertheless.